Hey Spectators, welcome back to my channel. And today, as you can see, my curls are like dull now. I'm due for a wash day. I wash my hair once a week. But I've gotten quite a bit of questions on how I had did my wash and go. First of all, let me just explain. That was the first time I ever nailed it. And the years of me being natural, the very first time I ever nailed a wash and go. Were asking me how I did it, what products I used, did I shingle, did I do this, did I do that. And I'm like, I don't remember what I did, I just know I nailed it. So I'm going to try to see if I can nail it on camera. So starting off, I'm using the Cream of Nature Pure Honey Moisturizing Dry Defense Shampoo. And it has pure honey rich coconut oil and creamy shea butter. One of the lines that my hair gets along with. Get ready to condition and detangle. I have to do this because when it comes time for me to do my hair mask and my wash and go, well, just my hair mask, let me just start with the hair mask, it's gonna be so hard for me to part my hair if I don't detangle it. So what I do is I use the Cream of Nature Pure Honey Moisturizing Dry Defense, and it's the conditioner. And then what I do is I part my hair in 16 waves. Sounds crazy, but my hair is not long enough for me to do 4-way part or 6-way part or even 8. So I do 16. And the reason why is because when it's time for me to do my hair mask, when I do my hair mask, I twist my hair and then I put on the cap. And if I do it 4 ways or 6 ways, 8, it's gonna come loose, and I really don't want that. So, by the way, when I detangle, I use a wide tooth comb. The Demon brush I find too harsh for me because my curls and coils are really tight, and it causes it to kind of rip hair out when I'm trying to. I don't like that, so wide tooth comb is the easiest thing I could do. So as you can see, I have my hair in 18 sections. So pretty much, to summarize it, you part it in 4 ways and then you put 4 sections in each part. So now it's time to condition and detangle. Get it done enough of it. Much of what I do is I just put a little bit of product in my hand. And at that moment, I had put in too much, but I just rub it in my hands. And then rub it across the ends of my hair. And I kind of like rub my hands on my ends to make sure I get all of the product on my hair. And then I take the wide tooth comb and just kindly detangle it. And it's the easiest way for me to do it. I want to try that new detangling brush that I've been seeing all over Instagram, but I don't know yet. Right now, the wide tooth comb is doing it for me, so very gentle. It's not super harsh on my hair. Okay, one side is done. So you obviously got the gist. So I'm going to do the other side off camera. And then I'll let you know what's going on next. Okay, so now that I have done the conditioning detangle, I'm going to put on the shower cap. I'm going to leave it on for 5 minutes. And then I'm going to rinse it off camera, come back, do my hair mask, and then we'll continue from there. So be back. Okay, now that I've rinsed out my hair, I'm going to go ahead and do the Creamy Nature Pure Honey Moisture Replenish and Strength Head Mask. And then I leave this in for 15 minutes. Well, it says 10 to 15, but I'm doing 15 minutes. I'm going to put on the shower cap and everything like that. Then I rinse that out, and I'll be done for the night. And then I'll start with my curl definition tomorrow morning. Air mask is completely done. 16 boo boo twists. And I'm gonna leave it in for 15 minutes. And then I'm gonna rinse it out, put on my microfiber cap, and then let it dry overnight. And then we'll continue from there. Hi, spectators, welcome back. And it is the next morning. My hair is completely dry. And I'm getting ready to start my wash and go. So first, I'm going to just tell you what I will be using. So I'll be using a spray bottle with water. I have like 3 clips for my hair. And then I have 4 ponytail holders because obviously I'm going to be sectioning it off. But it's a 4 this time. And then for my activator, my curl activator, this is what I was telling you about yesterday. It's this one. It's the shrinkage defense. It does work, but when I put the gel over it, it kind of shrinks it, which I don't care about because obviously when I stretched it, it just didn't look right. So this is Extreme Gel. I got it from my local beauty supply. First of all, I would say it was like fairly cheap for this big of a size. I think it was like $4.59 at my beauty supply for this. Now, if it was Eco Styler Gel, which my hair does not get along with, it probably would have cost it a lot more, like $8.99. And then I have my rat tail comb. So what I'm going to start with doing is just sectioning off my hair. I do need my mirror. Oh, I see it. So actually I'm going to take my pick and try to detangle as much as possible, because I found that last time when I did it, it was a little bit tough to part my hair because it was so clumped. So I'm kind of just like pulling on it, but not like literally, but just like kind of like you're stretching it, but you're not. Just kind of getting all those strands of hair unclumped. And then I'm going to try to lightly detangle it. So it's a lot easier for me to part my hair. And not even gonna lie, I find it a lot easier to do it with the Y2 comb, which is what I should have stuck with, because that's what I've been sticking with for a while. But I just seen it on the bed, and I was like, why not? But anyway, you could tell the difference between this and this. Like, my hair is, like, unclumped. That's what I want. So, let me finish detangling, and then we'll start. I'm sorry if I was making a certain face, but like, I get very concerned when I'm detangling my hair because I know how tight my curls are, so I get really concerned. And I personally do not like using detanglers. Like, they just don't work for me, and I feel like it's just extra buildup that I just don't need. So, I get really nervous when I'm trying to detangle my hair without one. But I much rather prefer it, because my hair, it just builds up there. It doesn't do anything for me. It doesn't actually detangle my hair. It just put product in my hair. That's how I feel. Maybe if you can find a great one, cool. But like me, I've tried some and it just did not work out. So just recommend me what you think I should use down below. Okay, so my hair is detangled. So now I'm just going to start out with the back section, and then I'll make my way to the front. Or should I do the side? I don't know. We're just gonna go to the side. Okay, so a small section in my hair, right? I don't know if you can see that, but that's how I do it. Then I take some water and I spray a little bit. Like, spray it, but barely spray it. Wait. Okay. So I spray it, and then I, like, kind of grab my hands and kind of just squeeze it all over my hair. Because, like I said, I have low porosity hair. So when it comes to water staying in my hair, it doesn't. So I try to like squeeze as much all over my hair as possible, all over my section. And it kind of gets out the excess as well. But you want it at least all over your strands, at least. But not too much. Like, so it's damp right now. So now I'm just going to take and split off into two sections. And then I'm going to pin this one up, which is why I had the clips. So let me see if I can zoom in so I can show you guys what's going on. So I'm going to take a tiny bit of this, which is the curl activator. Just a tiny bit. Well, it's a bit much. Don't grab this much, okay? But you're going to apply it all over. And you're probably going to look at it, you're probably going to be like, that's not doing anything. What's a curl activator? So, I'm just going to activate my curls. just like that. And then the way I grab the gel is I take the top of my fingers, grab a little bit, and just do like that. And then I apply the gel with it. Now, me personally, I don't need this much gel, but you could put as little or as much as you want. I put like the minimum. See how it's all coming together? Now, I personally don't leave it like this. I actually coil the ends. So I take it that's already clumped, and then I just twirl my finger. Because I personally don't like when my ends are just sticking out like that, especially when my hair is just not that long. So take your finger and twirl it. That's how I do it. See if I can zoom in some more. But this is how it looks. So I'm going to do it again to kind of show you guys again. So that's just pretty much how I do my curls. Until my hair gets longer, then maybe I could just shingle it and call it a day, but I have to twirl my ends or else it just would not look right for me. Okay, so I've completely finished a section.
Oh baby, I wanted you to be here inside my arms where the night goes down. Oh baby, I wanted you to be the sun comes up and the day goes by.
What I'm going to do is just, not that, obviously, but what I'm going to do is finish the rest off camera, and then I will show you guys the results, because this takes a long time, and I don't want to run out of memory before I get to the ending of it, so be right back, spectators. So, like, here's the finished result of my hair. And this is, like, the last section I kind of finished, and it's about dry. So, yes. Whew. I feel good, y'all. I feel so good. Ugh. but I hope you guys enjoyed, and later, spectators.